Hello students, welcome to CET Sankalp classes. In the last class, we started with thermal properties of matter lesson. So after synopsis, we have discussed three questions. So today let us start with the next question answers. The first question for today's class is, it is hotter for the same distance over the top of a fire than it is in the side of it. Mainly because, so here first understand the question, that is, it is hotter for the same distance. So it is hotter for the same distance over the top of a fire than it is in the side of it. Means if a fire is there at the top and at the side, here at the same distance, why it is more hot at the top, that they are asking here. So it is mainly because of, the options are, air conducts heat upwards. Heat is radiated upwards. Third option, convection takes more heat upwards. Fourth option, convection, conduction, and radiation all contribute significantly transferring heat upwards. So if you see all the options here, no doubt this process is because of, here whatever the heat is transferring, that is because of the convection, that is because of the convection process here. So here the right option is convection takes more heat in the upward direction, in the upward direction. So as you know the definition of convection, because of that reason we say that the convection takes more heat in the upward direction, therefore it is more heat at the top of a fire than at the side of it. So the right option is, that is option C here, the right option is option C. Then the next question is, that is, coefficient of volumetric expansion of solids and liquids is, coefficient of volumetric expansion of solids and liquid is. So this topic, it is based on thermal expansion. In that thermal expansion, we have volumetric expansion, area expansion, and linear expansion. So here the question is based on volumetric expansion, where due to the heat, there is an increase in volume of the body takes place, that is called as volume expansion. So coefficient of volume expansion of solid and liquid is. So as we know that we have three types of matter, that is solid, liquid and gases. In that, coefficient of volume expansion, where it will be more, where it will be more. So in compared to solid, liquid and gases, see options are, high with respect to gases means for solid and liquid it is more with respect to gases. Second option, it is low with respect to gases. Third option, it is equals to that of gases. And the fourth option is high at low temperature and low at high temperature. Here, whatever the options are there, first, second and third, that is comparing the solid and liquid with the gases. Here, volumetric expansion compared to for solid, liquid and gases. In case of gases, it is more. In case of gases, it is more compared to solids and liquids. Therefore, the right option is for solid and liquid, it is low with respect to gases. Suppose if they have given it for gases, then it is high for gases always. So here the correct option is, that is option B. Option B is correct, that is it is low with respect to gases. Okay students, let us see the next question. I hope these two questions are clear to you. The next question is, Next question is, there is a hole in the middle of a copper plate. When heating the plate, the diameter hole would be. So here there, you have a copper plate. At the middle of the copper plate, there is a hole. So when you heat it, what happens to the hole? So according to the thermal properties, thermal expansion concept, students, you know that when any substance is heated, here what happens? Whatever the thermal expansion is there, according to that, its dimension increases. Its dimension increases here. So here the options are, the diameter of the hole increases, decreases, it remains the same, none of this. So here the correct option is option A. That is, when metals are heated, it expands, therefore the diameter of the hole increases. The correct option is option A. Then our next question is, with rising temperature, density of a given body changes according to one of the following relation. See, here they are increasing the temperature. What happens to the density of a body? That we need to see. So we have a four equation here. In that, which is correct equation that we need to understand. So how you can do the solution here? Density is denoted by rho. And gamma is nothing but, here it is volume expansion. Here the solution can be written as you know that density is nothing but, mass per unit area. Density is nothing but, it is mass per unit area, correct? So here you can write, density rho is equal to mass per unit volume, density equal to mass per unit volume. What they are saying, they have a body here. When you increase the temperature, initially the density, if you take it as rho, then mass per unit volume. If you take, here we need to take the ratio after heating, if the density is rho naught, then here the mass can be written as, that is, this is divided by m divided by V naught. I hope you understood this. That is, rho is the density before heating the body, and it is written by mass per unit volume. Rho naught is the density of the body after heating. Now, if you simplify this equation, so here we have m by V whole divided by m by V naught. So mass term will get cancelled. Therefore, you will get it as rho divided by rho naught is equal to V naught divided by V. You will get it as rho divided by rho naught is equal to V naught divided by V. So we know that, already we know that is equal to, this is equal to V naught divided by, what is V? V can be written as, according to our volume expansion, we can also write it as 1 plus gamma delta T, 1 plus gamma delta T. So here this V naught and this V naught will get cancelled. So you are left with what here? You are left with only 1 divided by 1 plus gamma delta T. Here when it goes to the numerator, it becomes. So when it goes to the numerator, it becomes, here you can write it, it becomes 1 plus gamma delta T to the power of minus 1. Here, if you apply binomial expansion, the final equation can be written as, is equal to 1 minus gamma delta T. So this is what, after applying binomial expansion theorem. So what we are getting here, that is rho by rho naught is equal to 1 minus gamma delta T. Therefore, rho is equal to, density rho is equal to, we can write it as rho naught into bracket 1 minus gamma delta T. So students, here the correct option is option B. With increase in temperature, as we know that volume of the given body increases, therefore the density decreases. So the correct option is option B. I hope you understood this. So very simple question. So if you know thermal expansion, coefficient of thermal expansion concept, you can do this easily. Okay. So next we will see our next question here. Okay, students, our next question is, the temperature at which centigrade and Fahrenheit scales give the same reading is. So this we have already discussed while discussing the synopsis. So here the correct option is where the Celsius and Fahrenheit scales shows the same reading, that is for minus 40 degree. Here you can use the formula, that is which relates the Fahrenheit and the Celsius scale. If you take the temperature, both the temperature as theta and simplify the equation, you will get the option A, that is minus 40 degree. So this we have discussed during the synopsis class. Then our next question is, when temperature of water is raised from, zero to 4 degrees Celsius, so what happens to the water? So as we know that water shows a special behavior, or you can say special character, that is NMLS expansion behavior. So according to that, when a water is heated between 0 to 4 degrees Celsius, instead of expanding, it will contract. So therefore, the correct option is option B here, the water contracts. If you increase the temperature above 4 degrees Celsius, then it will start expanding. So this you know based on the definition of NMLS expansion of water. So, 8th question, the option is A, that is minus 40 degree. 9th question, the option is B, that is when water is heated between 0 to 4 degrees Celsius, it will contract. So, students, our next question is, the density of water at 4 degrees Celsius is. So, here they have given you the density of water at 4 degrees Celsius. Temperature is there, T1 is equal to 4 degrees Celsius and density is 1000 kg per meter cube. And at 100 degrees Celsius, it is 958.4 kg per meter cube. So here two temperatures are there, T1, T2, and two densities are there. The coefficient of volume expansion you need to calculate here. So to calculate coefficient of volume expansion here, as they have given you the density concept, you need to use the formula which relates the density with the coefficient of volume expansion, right? So here you can calculate first separately for one temperature, that is 100 degrees Celsius, and for 4 degrees Celsius, then you can simplify the answer here. Okay. So here, see, first we need to calculate before using the formula of density and coefficient of volume expansion. We need to calculate the densities equation for 4 degrees Celsius and for 100 degrees Celsius, right? So let us see how to calculate this. So here they have given you temperature. You can take T1 temperature, you can take T2 temperature. So any one temperature you can consider as. So here you can consider T1 as 100 degrees Celsius and T2 as 4 degrees Celsius. And you can see the corresponding densities of the body they have given. So let us solve this. That is density at T1 temperature is given by density at T1 temperature is given by, here you can take it as, that is rho T1 is equal to, it is 958. So here I'll solve it. You can see that is density at T1 temperature is, we can take it as 1000, and density at T2 temperature, I can take it as 958.4 kg per meter cube here. So here we have the formula. This just now we have discussed based on density and thermal coefficient. This is temperature, that is density at T2 temperature is equal to density at T1 temperature whole divided by 1 plus gamma into bracket delta T is equal to, delta T is nothing but what, T2 divided by T1, T2 minus T1 here. So substitute the values here, this implies, or here down I'll substitute the values. This is equal to 958.4 is equal to, this is 1000 whole divided by 1 plus. So gamma value only we need to calculate here. So keep the gamma as it is. Delta T, that is change in temperature, 1000 minus 4. So 1000 minus 4 is nothing but what? Here the students, the 100 minus 4, it is nothing but 96. So simplify this equation for gamma. So how you can simplify this? That is 1 plus gamma into bracket 96 is equal to 1000 divided by 958.4. So divide this value. Here after dividing, you will get it around 1.043. And here you can subtract that 1. That is 1.43 minus 1 becomes 0.43 divided by 96. So if you simplify this equation, you will get answer approximately equal to, you will get the answer approximately equal to, that is option C here, that is 4.5 into 10 raised to minus 4. You will get actually 4.47 something. So approximately equal as 4.5 into 10 raised to minus 4 per degree Celsius. So this is your 10th question. So let us see the next question here. Next question is the latent heat of Vaporization of a substance is always, the latent heat of vaporization of a substance is always, option A, greater than its latent heat of fusion, greater than its latent heat of sublimation, equal to its latent heat of sublimation, B option, less than its latent heat of fusion. So already you know the definition of latent heat of fusion, sublimation and vaporization. So here they are comparing vaporization with fusion and sublimation. So as we know that the latent heat of vaporization is always greater than latent heat of fusion, because in liquid to vapor phase, there is a change. When there is a change in the state, the increase in volume takes place. Hence, here more heat is required as compared to solid to liquid phase change. That is option A is the correct one. Compared to vapor, latent heat of vaporization greater than latent heat of fusion here. Latent heat of fusion. Then our next question, that is 12th question we have here. 540 gram of ice at 0 degree Celsius, 540 gram of ice at 0 degree Celsius when it is mixed with 540 gram of water. So here the masses are same, and for water the temperature is 0 degree Celsius and for water it is 80 degree Celsius. Here the final temperature of mixture you need to calculate. So final temperature of mixture, how you can calculate this? We have, based on the specific heat capacity or based on the heat lost by the body concept, also you can calculate this. Here we know that Q is equal to heat required to change the state is given by Q is equal to, for ice we will calculate first. So first I'll calculate for ice here. Here you can see that is Q1 is equal to M into L, that is mass into latent heat. So you can calculate heat taken by the ice to melt at 0 degree Celsius and heat taken by the water to cool up to 0 degree Celsius. So Q1 is equal to M into L. This is equal to, so mass of water. So what is mass of water here? 540 into. Here you can take this as 540 into 80. So if you multiply 540 into 80, how much you will get here? You will get it around 43,200. So this is for what? Heat taken by ice to melt at 0 degree Celsius. Similarly, calculate heat given by water to cool up to 0 degree Celsius. So that I can calculate here. That is Q2 is equal to. So Q2 is equal to Ms delta theta, which is equal to. So here mass is 540, S is 1, and delta theta, change in temperature. Here it is 80 minus 0. So here if you simplify and calculate, here also you will get it as 43,200 calories. Hence, heat given by water is just sufficient to melt the whole ice, and final temperature of mixture is, so here 43,200 minus 43,200. So final answer, what you will get it here? Here the students, the answer is option A. So when you mix ice to water of same mass, here the final temperature will be 0 degrees Celsius. Remember this. Our next question is, 100 gram of ice is mixed to 100 gram of water at 100 degree Celsius. What will be the final temperature? So here you can use the principle of calorimetry, and here you can calculate the final temperature here. If you use the principle of calorimetry, the formula is heat lost by the body is equal to what? Heat gained by the body. Heat lost by the body is equal to heat gained by the body. So you can write the formula as ms delta theta is equal to ms plus m into L. So here you just calculate the final temperature by applying delta theta is equal to what? Theta 2 minus theta 1. So simplify the equation, and here the option A is the correct one. So you just take, that is mass as 100, S value as 1, then delta theta is equal to, so m into L plus m into S. So if you do here, you will get the option A, that is 10 degrees Celsius, that is 10 degrees Celsius. So let us see the next question. So 13th question, you just simplify by using the formula, you will get the option A. Place the following in increasing order of the amount of heat required. So here you need to place the following in the amount of heat required, means where it is more heat requirement is there, where vaporizing 1 kg of water or melting 1 kg of ice, heating 1 kg of warm from water from 0 to 100 degrees Celsius. So where you require more heat. See here, whatever the process they have given, the vaporization of 1 kg of water, it requires the heat of 2.3 into 10 raised to 6 joules. So for A option, it requires heat of 2.3 into 10 raised to 6 joules, and melting of 1 kg of ice requires 3.3 into 10 raised to 5 joules, and heating it from 0 to 100 degrees Celsius, it requires heat from 4.2 into 10 raised to 5 joules. Here, therefore, the thus in increasing order, they will be. So if you see the heat required, in first case, it is 2.3. In second case, it is 3.3 into 10 raised to 5. In third case, it is 4.2. Here, option D is correct. That is, melting require more heat. Second one is heating of 1 kg of ice. Then the third one is A, that is vaporizing 1 kg of water. So correct option is option B, that is B, C, A. Melting require more heat, increasing order. Means increasing order in the sense, first is melting, then second is heating. Vaporizing require more heat. Vaporization process require more heat. So that is at the top. When you are creeping in the increasing order from lowest to highest, we will go. So the correct option is option D. Then the next question is, steam burns are more serious as. So why steam burns are more serious? See, the options are steam at 100 degrees Celsius carries same heat as that of water 100 degrees Celsius, but pressure of steam is more. Option B, steam is more reactive. Option C, steam has less surface tension and so it burns more rapidly. Option D, that is steam at 100 degrees Celsius carries more heat than water at 100 degrees Celsius. So here the steam gives more burning sensation. Why? Because option D is correct. That is, steam at 100 degrees Celsius carries more heat than water at 100 degrees Celsius. So the correct option is option D. 14 and 15, both the options are B only here. Then our next question, two liquids A and B are at 32 degrees Celsius and 24 degrees Celsius. When mixed in equal masses, the temperature of the mixture is found to be 28 degrees Celsius. So mixture temperature also they have given as 28 degrees Celsius. Their specific heat ratio they have asked you. So how to do this one, specific heat ratio? Here also you can use the concept of heat lost by the body is equal to heat gained by the body. So if you use the concept here, if you simplify this, you will get the option as, see here, the solution is something like this. Heat lost by the body is equal to heat gained by the body, that is M S A into bracket 32 minus 38. Temperature they have given is equal to, two bodies are there, A and B, is equal to M into SB into bracket 28 minus 24. So if you simplify this, see here, 32 minus 38 and 28 minus 24, you will get the option that is 4 only. So M masses are same, therefore it will get cancelled. Therefore the option SA is equal to SB. So SA is equal to SB in the sense what? That is 1 is to 1. So the correct option is option C is correct here. Option C is correct, that is 1 is to 1. Next question. Which of the following statement is correct? So convection is a mode of heat transfer by actual motion of matter. Yes, this we know already. Convection is because of the actual motion of the water. So this is correct. Convection is possible only in gases. No. So students, as we know that this is not true. It is applicable in liquid also. So second is wrong. Convection can be a natural or forced one. So here convection can be a natural process or it can be a forced process. Yes, this is also true here. Therefore, see, option only one is correct. No. Both one and three it is correct. Only two is correct. All of these it is correct. So option B, that is one and third is correct. One and third one is correct. Our next question is, in which of the following process convection does not take place primarily? So in which case the convection does not take place? Sea and land bridge. Then our next option is trade wind, boiling of water. Then last option is warming of glass of bulb due to filament. See, in first three cases, it is in liquid or the gaseous state. So as we know that in liquid or gaseous state, the convection process takes place. Option 4, that is warming of a glass of bulb due to filament. Here the radiation process takes place. Therefore, the option D, that will not follow the convection process primarily. Next question. The common example of forced convection system are. So the common example for a forced system are in human blood circulatory system, cooling system of an automobile engine, human liver system, water cycle. So in all the process here, what happens? In which convection is forced one they have asked you. See, human blood circulatory system, cooling system of automobile engine, liver system and water cycle. Options are only first one is correct. No, it is not right. Both 1 and 2. So here 1 and 2, human blood circulatory system and automobile engine, they are example for forced convection process. They are example for forced convection process. So option B is correct here. Next question. A black body at 2000 Kelvin emits radiation with, so black body at temperature they have given 2000 Kelvin, radiation wavelength is 1250 nanometer. If for the radiation coming from the star Sirius, the wavelength value is 71 nanometer, then find the temperature of this star. So how you can calculate the students? Here you can use the Wien's displacement law and you can calculate it. So let us see the calculation part. That is according to Wien's displacement formula, we can take T2 divided by T1 is equal to. So as we know that it is reciprocal of the lambda value. So this is lambda m by lambda m. Here you can consider it for first case. Here you can consider it for second case. So here we need to calculate the value of T2. So T2 value can be calculated as what? Lambda m for the temperature 2000 Kelvin you can take. So here if you substitute the value, it is 2000 into 1250 divided by 71. So just substitute the value. After substituting, if you calculate, the answer is option A, that is 35211 Kelvin. 35211 Kelvin, that is the correct answer here. Next question, heat travels through vacuum by, that is conduction, convection, radiation, both A and B. As we know that heat travels through the process of radiation. So the correct option is option C, that is radiation. Our next question is, if between wavelength lambda and lambda plus d lambda, E lambda and A lambda be the emissive and absorptive powers of a body and capital E lambda be the emissive power of a perfectly black body, then according to Kirchhoff's law, which is true? So according to Kirchhoff's law, which is true, that we need to see here. So by the concept of Kirchhoff's laws of emissive power and absorptive power, here we can calculate and we can simplify the answer as, that is, here the simplification is so according to Kirchhoff's law, the ratio of emissive power to absorptive power is same, it is same for all bodies, is equal to the emissive power of a perfectly bodies. Therefore, here we can write it as, that is E divided by A for a body is equal to emissive power of a black body. So this is according to the statement. For a particular wavelength, here we can write it as, that is E lambda divided by A lambda is equal to E lambda for perfectly black body. Therefore, we need E lambda is equal to. So in the given option, if you simplify, you will get the answer C here. This is according to the Kirchhoff's laws. Then the next question is, an ideal black body at room temperature is thrown into a furnace. It is observed that here what happens, initially it takes, options are initially it is the darkest body and at later times the brightest. Second one, it is a darker body at all the times. Third one, it cannot be distinguished at all the times. Fourth one, initially it is the darkest body and later times it cannot be distinguished. So here option A is right, that is initially black body absorbs all the radiant energy incident on it. So it is the darkest one. Black body radiates maximum energy if all other conditions are same. So when the temperature of the black body becomes equal to the temperature of the furnace, it will be the brightest of all. So the correct option is option A. Correct option is option A here. So we have completed 23 questions. Few more questions are there which we will discuss in the next class. So thank you, students.